great joy indeed to come into your home, brothers and sisters. We're talking about new beginning, Rosh Hashanah, and this year of taking possession. We are praying for you that you are going to take possession, much more that God has for you. And of course, we appreciate your support, keeps the ministry going for you and for others. And this new season, we talk about how Joshua's people got new supply when they crossed the Jordan, no longer the manna. It is now the fresh supply from the land. And same way in the Rema Holy Communion, we premiere on Tuesday with a new one. But on Wednesday and Saturday, we have highlights. But Hamrumers know, the more you hear, the more you listen, you can experience the heavenly power on this earth. Today, Krishna season, we're going to talk about a day of double goodness. Even in the midst of all the challenging time. You know, the second day of creation, God never said, it is good. Every other day of creation, He said, good. And He made the mountains, He made the sky, but the land was still dark. There was no sun. But on the third day, He said, good, two times. Was then God called the dry ground land and gathered waters He called seas. And God said, it was good. Then God said, let the land produce vegetation, seed-bearing plants and trees on land that bear fruit, harvest, with seed according to the various kind. And it was so. The land produced vegetation, plants bearing seed according to their kinds, and trees bearing fruit, harvest, according to its kind. And God saw, you know what? It was good. The land produced vegetation, all sort of seed bearing plants, produced plants and trees and great harvest. And He said, wow. He declared, good twice. It is a day of double goodness. But yet, there was no sun. It's dark. And yet, in spite of that, man, we learn one thing, darkest time is a day of double goodness. God can turn it around. Now, where does a plant got the energy to grow and bear fruit? I tell you, I believe it is the supernatural light. It's not an it. This light, it's not an it. The sun was not even created. It is a person, and it is a him, he. And who is that light? Christmas reminds us that the people living in darkness seen the great light, with great light of those living in the land of the shadow of death, the gloom and the doom, a light has dawned. And in the darkness, the people saw a great light. And what is that light? That light of the world. Jesus Christ said, I am the light of the world. Not to expose people, the fault and this and that, is to bring us to the right path, the light that brings us the right direction. And Dr. Jim, of course, highlighted this, the same. When we were in the Holy Land, the guide also tells us that people love to have a wedding on the third day, our Tuesday, because it's a day of double blessing. The first miracle that Jesus Christ performed in Cana of Galilee on the third day, our Tuesday. On the third day, a wedding took place in Cana, in Galilee. Now, what is the key to the first miracle? Jesus was there. And it's almost 1,000 days, more than 1,000, in fact, since the COVID pandemic hit this world, immensely challenging time, many challenges. And but just when we think all is lost, God brings the light of the world, double goodness. He turned everything into good. It tells me one thing, God's blessing is not hinged to circumstances. In fact, the writer of the Psalm say, a single day spent in your temple is better than 1,000 anywhere else. And God is able to pick up what you lost. Just one day, what you can't in the 1,000. What is the key? In the Lord's house. In other words, His presence. The first day of the week, come to His house. First part of the day, spend time. And then you can experience the third day, our Tuesday, without the light of the sun. It was double goodness. There was great harvest. So our blessings not hinge the circumstances. And we get able to great harvest because of the supernatural. So this Christmas, we're celebrating that light of the world coming. Do share the good news and invite people to come for all our Christmas events. There's going to be great food and get an invite and see the great light in the midst of our challenges. Ola bara shalom baraka irianda baraka shalom bara hiria. Get rid of your element. Ola bara shalom barakirianda la barakia. Ola bara kirianda la bara shalom baraka. Orianda la barakiria. Kirianda la baraka. The Lord Jesus Christ, take and eat. This is my body broken for you. This cup is a new covenant in my blood. Pour out for you for the forgiveness of all your sins. Ola bara kirianda la bara shalom bara hirianda. Orianda la baraka, propel. Indeed, that is a word for you. He will propel you beyond what you can. Even in the midst of challenging situation, God will just give you that creative idea. The key is Him, the light. In these times of uncertainty, great challenges, very important to get the right direction. And then that right step that you take boldly with His leading, will cause you to be propelled beyond. Oda bara hirianda la bara. Spend time in His presence. Spend time. First day of the week, first part of the day. Oda bara hirianda la. Heart condition. In the name of Jesus Christ, be made whole. In depression, be gone. Gloom and doom, be gone. In the mighty name of Jesus. Prostrate condition, be healed. In the mind, the constant ring, be gone in the mighty name of migraine condition, be healed in Jesus' name. Ola la bara hirianda, shalom bara kriya, inana barandirianda la masaya. The Lord bless you, give you the Lord causes His face to shine upon you, be gracious unto you. He smiles on you and releases you His favor. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen and amen. Do continue to worship and take turn to pray. Short prayer and close with perhaps a song of praise among you. Amen, amen. Love you, miss you.